My name is a real place. It's where they found me when I was a baby. I used to imagine it was the beautiful woods, surrounded by bright, colorful flowers, singing birds, and a lush green landscape. Truth was, it was a street corner in Queens. That's where I was left, 1 hour old, with nothing but a scrap of paper that said, "Call her Hollis Woods." By the time I was 12, I'd been in 5 foster homes. And when I finally thought I'd found a family of my own, I went and messed it all up. I was always trouble for somebody, from the very beginning.
I want you to think of this as a brand new start. You're turning over a new leaf, Hollis Woods. She's a very nice woman. Plus, she's an art teacher. Mr. Regan wanted you to keep up your art.
I don't care.
Well, I suggest you start. I'm a social worker, not a magician. We're running out of options for you, you know? You need to make this work.
Must be
Hollis Woods. Hollis, this is Ms. Kale.
Hello, Hollis. I don't bite Hollis, I promise. I don't, but he does. You'll have to excuse him. He's got very bad manners, haven't you, Henry?
Out you go. Josie, it's good to see you. It's been a long time.
It has.
We so appreciate what you're doing.
It's my pleasure. Won't you come in for some tea or coffee, lemonade?
I'll just let Hollis get settled in.
I'm settled.
Oh, so she does have a voice after all.
Oh, she has a voice, all right. Here, I'll come pick you up on Monday, take you to school. Get you introduced to all the kids around here. You and Ms. Kale, take care. Call me if there's any problems.
Oh, there won't be. Goodbye.
Bye.
I've taken care of quite a few girls, Fred, over the years. You can call me Josie. My last name is spelled C-A-H-I-L-L, but it's pronounced Kale, like vegetables. What should I call you, Holly or Hollis?
Not Holly.
Oh, well then, Hollis. Just drop your bag anywhere. This is my place. I've lived here since they invented the spoon.
Who invented the spoon?
I don't know. The knife and fork people, I guess. This is my studio.
Are these real people?
Some of them.
What about her?
That's my cousin Beatrice. I could make one of you, you know. We'd have to find the right piece of wood first. All starts with the wood. Oh, let's see. Oh, this might do. Maybe not. How about this? No. You know, these carvings take a long time. I can't start one unless you decide to stay. I tell you what, if you'll stay, I'll see to it that Henry here is on his best behavior. You hear that, Henry? We're putting it all on you. If you were a naughty kitty, young Hollis here just might skedaddle out the front door. What was I doing?
The right piece of wood?
Yes. It all starts with the wood. Here it is. I found the perfect piece. That doesn't have Hollis Woods written all over it. I don't know what does. Oh, that is just right. You all settled in? Oh, did you draw those? Edna told me you were an artist. Who's that?
Nobody.
I like to paint the ocean and the flowers I grow. What do you like to draw?
Things that happen.
Well, maybe you'll show me sometime. Here's some towels and, if you need anything, I'm right down the hall. Good night.
Even if I wanted to, which I didn't, I couldn't explain to her what had happened earlier that summer or how I'd messed things up.
Oh, Edna. Well, our little girl here is ready for her big adventure. Well, bye, Hollis. Have a wonderful summer.
Get on the bus.
Did you see that?
She's having a tough time. You're gonna have a great summer.
Let me guess. She doesn't want me back.
I'll find another placement in September. Look, Hollis, this family is willing to take you on for a few months and give you an experience you've never had before. Down the country.
Yeah, out in the boonies.
Just try to enjoy it. Try to make the most of it. Just try, Hollis.
Who's here to meet you?
Hey, Hollis? Are you Hollis?
Yeah.
Hi. I'm Isabella Regan, but everybody calls me Izzy.
Hi, and I'm John.
So happy to meet you.
Are you here to sign for her?
I'll sign it. She's our summer kid.
I think we need an adult.
Yeah, an adult.
Picture ID, please. Thank you. Just sign there.
Yeah, you're like an overnight package.
Steven.
And this impolite young man is our son, Steven.
Hi.
There you go, miss. Take care.
Thank you.
Well, welcome to Hancock.
Oh, our car's just over here. Where's your luggage?
This is it.
Oh, great. Well, then we're all set. Let's go.
She offered to take her bag.
I can carry it.
See? She can carry it. Otherwise, I would have offered. Hey, how about I drive?
Yeah, how about you get in the back?
What? I already drive the truck.
Yeah, you're learning and only at the cabin.
Come on, Dad.
In, Steven, in.
So this is just our summer home, Hollis. It's nothing fancy or anything.
Yeah, nothing fancy. Like nothing at all.
I didn't know what you like to eat, so I have turkey, ham, or peanut butter. Any of those sound good?
Turkey's okay.
Great. Sold.
You know, we might as well break it to her, Dad. It's not like she won't find out. No TV, no DVDs, no video games, and no internet. Not even dial-up, because there's not a phone.
It's a break from distractions and stress. Love it, Hollis. I hope you do, too. But, Steven...
Don't worry, we're going to have a wonderful summer.
Thank you.
Hear that river, Hollis? My favorite sound in the world to go to sleep to.
This is the old folks. I'm up in the loft. And this is you. My mom's going through a green phase. It used to be blue. It was gonna be my brother's room.
What happened to him?
He died.
Oh.
Last year. He was a baby.
Steven, your dad needs a hand unloading.
Ah, Mom.
Tough life, kid. Don't forget to bring in your books.
I won't.
I think Steven's excited to have a new friend for the summer. We usually send him part of the time to camp, but we want the whole family to be together this year. We've never done this before, hosted a child. So anything you need, anything, you just ask, okay? We really want you to enjoy your stay here, Hollis.
Grown-ups always hope things are going to turn out great.
Time to go, Hollis.
I'm coming.
Later that year, Josie was hopeful too. But not me.
Morning, Linda.
Edna.
Good morning. Oh, hold your horses. Hollis, I packed you a lunch. There. Have a fun day at school.
Yeah, like that'll happen.
Anything could happen. We could win $1 million.
Or get hit by an asteroid.
Well, let's hope for the $1 million.
Everything's all set. You're in.
They don't want me here.
Yes, they do. Come on.
Your homeroom is 113.
I know. I've done the new school routine about 100 times.
Okay, what's your bus route home?
Number 7. I get off at Roland Road. The bus lady's Mrs. Puzo. I'm not an idiot.
No one has ever accused you of that. Hollis, if you want friends, you have to make friends.
What's the point? I probably won't even be here in a month.
We have a new student joining us today. Please stand up and tell the class your name. Don't be shy.
My name's Hollis. Hollis Woods.
Hollywood.
No. Hollis. Woods.
Hollis Woods.
All right. All right, all right. Settle down. Hollis, is there anything about yourself you'd like to share with the class?
No, ma'am.
All right. Well, regardless, we're all very happy to meet you.
Morning.
Hey, Josie. Do you have anything hidden away that I can take for lunch?
About a can of soup. Cream of, what is it, those little brown things?
Cream of mushroom?
That's it.
I don't like that stuff. I told you that, like a week ago.
Have you been here a week already? Ah, well, I'm flattered. Henry, are you flattered? What should we do to celebrate? Oh, I know. I'm going to take you to one of my favorite places. What time is it? 8:30. Good. The light will be perfect. Wait a minute. Is it a school day?
No. No, there's no school today. There's a teacher's conference.
Oh, good. We better bundle up, because we're taking the silver bullet.
Don't blink or you'll miss town.
Sweet, isn't it?
I moved up here about 100 years ago to live with my cousin Beatrice. That's our movie theater. You like the movies?
You get in free.
Joseph, oh, for heaven's sake. Go around.
There's other cars on the road, lady.
Seatbelt, good idea. I should have warned you next time I will.
Next time you won't have to.
Stick around, I'll teach you to drive. Oh, I love this ocean.
I like the river.
Well, there's saltwater people and there's freshwater people. And there are people who don't like either one. But they're not us.
You weren't born here?
No. I moved here to live with my cousin Bea when I was about your age. You'll meet her one of these days. When you do, you better keep your hands in your pocket.
Why?
You know what she did the first time I ever met her? She said, if we're going to share a room, you're either going to be my mortal enemy or my best friend. Which is it going to be? Then she grabbed my finger, stuck it with a pin, and made me a blood sister. Crazy Bea.
Why did you have to live with her anyway?
My parents died. I had nowhere else to go. You have a wonderful eye.
You have a wonderful eye.
We have four wonderful eyes.
Dear Ms. Hornsby, please excuse Hollis from being absent from school yesterday. Hollis had a severe rash. We learned that she's allergic to tomatoes. Pity, she really enjoys them. Yours sincerely, Miss Josie Kale.
This penmanship is excellent. Did you know that Miss Kale taught here for many years?
Here?
And for someone who could draw so beautifully, her handwriting was awful.
Oh.
Take this to the principal's office.
Please try.
Yeah.
Busted.
No way.
Oh, yes. And he chased that dog right up the tree.
You're going to make milk come out of my nose.
Oh, I hate when that happens.
You're making my arms so long.
So you're giving arms. Arms of generosity.
Oh, I'll get that. Miss Kale's residence.
Hollis? Hollis, is that you?
Hi, Edna.
You're not at school?
No, but I am sick.
Go get in the bed.
All right.
Drink lots of liquids and rest.
I will, I promise.
Let me talk to Joe.
Actually, she's kind of... she's kind of busy right now. But I'll tell her to call you back.
Make sure you tell her.
Who was that?
Wrong number.
Oh.
I think we're good on candy.
Oh, okay. Tomato soup.
Our cart's full of soup. What we don't have is milk, sandwich stuff, and food for Henry.
Oh, good thinking.
Okay. I'll get the bread and the cat food. You get the milk.
Okay. Done.
Left your purse where anyone could take it. The milk's back there.
Oh, the milk. I swear they move things around so much here, I can't find anything.
How long does this have to last us?
Oh, a couple of weeks, I guess.
I think we ought to budget.
I had one of those when I was little. Bright green and yellow. Flew out the window one day. Never saw it again. Budgies. Hate to be kept in cages.
I said budget. Budget, as in planning how to spend your money. What's left of it anyway? Josie?
Do I have a treat for you? We're going to the movies.
What do we do for money?
Oh, who needs money when you got Beatrice for a cousin? This is yours. To keep.
Then when you leave,
this is I'll leave.
Well, you didn't say you'd stay.
I'm thinking I should.
Well, I better congratulate Henry then, hadn't I?
Don't carry on.
The future was starting to look bright again with Josie. If I could just stop thinking about the past.
What, that's three words. Is it a book? A song?
I did this.
Yeah, I know you did that. What's it supposed to be?
Song.
A song. Dad, this song. Okay, all right, guys, come on. Just play the game. Hollis, do you want to play?
No. She'd rather draw Dad making a total fool of himself.
He's up. This is supposed to be fun. First word.
Oh, yeah, Mom. This is so much fun.
You're an ape. I don't...
Oh, I'm sorry. I was clearing out your drawers so you can make yourself at home.
It's okay. I like to keep my stuff together.
Oh, yeah, I get it. Night. You have a lovely way about you, Hollis. I'm glad you're here. Night.
Night.
Morning, Hollis. Wow,
Wow. That's really good. Have you taken lessons?
No.
You mind if I... You have talent. Stop!
Dad, I was just showing Hollis.
Showing off for Hollis, you mean. Mind the truck with you?
No, but you're under 10 yards away.
Doesn't matter if I'm 10 inches away. You don't drive unless I'm in the cab with you.
Okay, I'll put it back.
No, you won't put it back because that would be driving without me in the cab. Why don't you take Hollis fishing? She's been waiting.
I think that's a great idea. Come on, Hollis.
Come on.
I thought about letting you drown, but my parents would disown me.
Are you drilling that fish or smoking it, Dad?
Hollis, this is the largest trout I've ever seen taken out of that river.
I hate you already. This is fun, huh? Glad you came out into the country with us, Hollis. Don't worry, the mosquitoes. Dad'll smoke them out.
What's that?
What?
Dad, you see that?
Fireflies? Never seen fireflies before? Yep, the mosquitoes out here have headlights.
Call of the Wild by Jack London.
Hey, that's a good book. But isn't that on your reading list?
Yeah, but I'm reading some other book.
Huh.
What?
Okay. Well, we're gonna get some groceries. Hollis, is there anything special you want? All right, well, while we're gone, why don't you read that other book?
Okay, okay.
Hi, kid.
I didn't mean to get you in trouble.
Oh, it's okay. But hey, now that they're gone, go on. Third, put in third. Where's the third? Give it some gas.
This is so cool! I can't believe I'm driving the truck.
Yeah.
was just about the only person I ever met who made me want to have fun. That is, until Josie and her cousin B.
Nice atmosphere.
Well, look who's here.
Hollis, this is Beatrice Gilchrist, my cousin and best lifelong friend. Not counting Henry, of course.
Josie's told me all about you. You are quite the artist, I hear. I'm coming over and seeing your work before I leave town.
Oh, you're not leaving for ages. Beatrice is going to New Mexico. She's going to paint the desert. Lucky thing.
Just take your pick of seats, ladies. School nights are always slow.
Thanks.
Ladies, I'll take your tickets right over here.
Popcorn, ladies?
Oh, yes. It's a special recipe we dreamed up years ago. Fresh butter with,
parsley and chives.
I used to sell popcorn here on Tuesdays and Thursdays. Help Beatrice run the place.
Did you get to watch the movies?
Well, of course she watched the movies. You think I paid her? Excuse me while I start the projector.
Crazy bee.
Oh, Adam, I tried so hard. Poor little heart of yours.
Beatrice lives upstairs.
It's like a bone in the alley up there. Can you imagine?
Shh, lady.
Good. I hope you're not cooking because Beatrice is bringing dinner. It's those, those little, Oh, what is it? Shoot. It's,
Delicious?
You know, those little,
Pasta? Pizza? Sounds like...
I don't know, but it'll be delicious. Yoo-hoo! There she is. Supper's here.
Chinese food.
Of course. It's what we always have. The first time I ever laid eyes on Bea, she looked at me and said, if I have to share a room with you, you'll be my mortal enemy or my best friend. Which is it going to be?
Oh, I did not.
Don't believe a word of this, Hollis. I was scared to death of you.
She scared me to death. I said, I'll be your friend. I'll be your friend. And then she grabbed my finger and pricked me with a pen.
Well, I was 14 and going through my dramatic stage.
And she poked her own finger, pressed it to mine, and said, there, we're blood sisters from here on out.
Well, it stuck, didn't it?
It stuck all right.
Enough dilly-dallying. I came here to see some art.
Show her, Hollis.
Josie, you lied to me. Girl is not good. She's amazing. This gesture here, revelation through a detail like that, that is the sign of an artist. Interesting choice. Well, this is my favorite.
Of course.
Look, D.B., I'm supposed to know my way around. This John Doe movement's cost you a fortune. Now, this convention's going to cost plenty.
I can't run the phone.
Josie, it's the door.
Oh.
Oh, wait, Josie, don't answer.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
What a surprise.
Oh, I bet it is. Hollis, is there any reason you aren't at school again?
School?
I guess we overslept.
Oh, it's my fault. I kept her up late last night watching old movies.
I thought it was your tomato allergy acting up.
You poor thing, why didn't you tell me? I've been feeding her tomatoes up to the eyebrows.
You didn't even tell her I rang the other day either, did you?
Can I make you some tea?
No tea, thank you. You have 2 minutes to get dressed and ready for school. Which is where she's supposed to be, Josie, every day, unless she's got a legitimate excuse. These are envelopes. They are addressed to me. They don't need any postage. Every week, Hollis needs to give you a completed attendance card. And every week, you need to get those cards to me. Without fail.
Oh, okay, without fail.
Hurry.
It's my fault. I told Josie it was a school holiday.
Oh, I thought that was last week.
Okay. Come on. I'm sure this is working out.
But I like it here. I'll go to school. Every day. I'll get good grades. You'll see.
Okay. Guess we will.
You need to work on your spelling, Craig.
Okay.
You didn't read the assignment, did you?
Well, I started to.
And Hollis? Nice work.
If I really tried, I could make things work. It was such a cool feeling. I hadn't felt that way since summertime.
Be careful climbing up. Favorite spot. Wonder if I should give you half or you did all myself.
You should give me the whole thing. I deserve it.
That's what Dad would say.
You guys fight a lot, huh?
Yeah. He's getting worse. Doesn't want me to do anything on my own. Big or little. Which end?
That one.
Little. Yeah, that was a good one, Mom.
I don't care. Now there's some paper in this house.
I'm not gonna drop it.
Steven.
Hey.
Yeah,
I found this. An old box of some things of mine. And I want you to have it. Izzy?
Yeah?
I gotta go fix that old screen door.
Aw, you're my hero.
Steven, why don't you come with me?
Do
Come on, buddy. Let's go.
Never had so many colors to work with.
You know, my mother gave me that drawing kit for my 10th birthday. I could draw killer spaceships, but never people. Beautiful.
Mr. Regan was the first person who ever made me feel like a real artist. Josie and Bee were the next.
Oh, honey! Bee!
They were pretty funny together.
Josie, I need your mega-sized suitcase. I sat on mine, tried to force it, broke the zipper.
Oh, no.
Hollis, could you get the suitcase?
Where is it?
Is it in the closet?
Oh.
Holy cow, Josie. You need to clean this out. Got it.
Where are you off to?
Are you kidding? In Mexico, to paint the desert. We've been talking about it for ages.
Oh, right.
Are you all right?
I'm fine.
Josie, if you're not all right, I'll postpone.
Beatrice, I'm fine.
You sure?
Of course I'm sure. What more do you want me to say?
Okay. You can always call me if there's a problem.
Exactly.
I'll write down my cell.
Beatrice, I know your number. You've been the same one forever. Oh, have fun. And say hello to George O'Keefe for me.
Oh, you are all right, you silly thing.
Of course I am. Just ask Henry.
Call me if you need anything.
We will.
Hollis? Adios, amigos.
Crazy bee. Cleaning the closet? Can you help me move this?
Everything looks pretty good, Josie. I think you've done it. For now. I have an idea. How about we go to bed?
Good idea.
I'll tuck you in. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. See you next year.
Next year? Oh, yeah, next year. Merry Christmas.
Hollis.
I was in school. I just got off the bus. You can check.
Edna and I were just visiting over tea. Edna, and you'll never guess what I did. You know those forms I was supposed to mail? To Edna? Well, I mailed the gas payment instead. Have you ever heard of anything so dumb? The gas company is probably reading your attendance record right now.
That's not a big deal. It was just the wrong envelope. That could happen to anyone.
I know. Hollis, Josie and I were just talking, and we both agree that maybe it's time for a change.
What do you mean? Don't you want me anymore?
Is Hollis leaving?
That's what we were just talking about. I'd like to talk to Hollis outside for a moment. Josie, thanks again for the tea.
It was delicious.
Tell me what was going on here.
What?
You know what I'm talking about.
I'm not going.
Hollis, Ms. Kale is supposed to be taking care of you.
She is. She just forgets stuff sometimes. You don't know Josie.
I've known her for 20 years. This is something more than just forgetfulness. She's a serious problem. It's only gonna get worse, sweetie. Miss Kale cannot be responsible for you anymore.
You finally found a place I like, and now you're just dragging me away.
I'm not dragging you. You'll have time to say goodbye tonight. We'll come for you in the morning, okay?
To go where?
You'll go to the shelter until we can find you another placement. I am so sorry this didn't work out. I promise you can come and visit. I'll come and get you at 9 in the morning. With your backpack. Come on, get in the house.
Here. We have to pack. We have to go.
With Henry?
Yeah, with Henry. And cat food. And your toothbrush. And we've got to call B. This is an emergency.
Call B.
Josie, they're going to take me away. And I can't leave you alone. What's B's number?
What's B's number? What is B's number?
What's her number? Josie, we're going to a cabin for Christmas. There's no one there. It'll be just you and me and Henry.
Can we go tomorrow?
No, we have to go now.
Get my pillow.
There's your pillow. Okay, come on, let's go.
We have to go now.
We have to go now. It'll be all right. Okay, let's go.
Eyes on her, I had
to... You had to share a room with me.
That's what happened. Somebody died and I had to share a room with B.
She said, you're either gonna be my best friend or my mortal enemy. And you chose a friend. And she pricked her finger with a pin and she did the same with yours. Pressed them together. Blood sisters.
Crazy Bee.
It was much easier to help Josie recall her memories than to think of my own.
Hey.
Can I help?
Yeah. Wanna try? Thanks. Well, this was my mom's china. It's all cracked and chipped, but I love it anyway. You know, we had 12 of these plates when I was a kid. Down to 5. Steve breaks things. I was one of lots of kids. It's not gonna happen for us, so. I especially wanted it for Steven. It means a lot to us. Being here this summer. I love setting another place at our table.
My dream of a family was gone by the night of that trip with Josie. Okay, we're all set. Wake up, Josie. Josie! Hey. Josie, we gotta go. We gotta go. We can't stay here. Josie?
Mm-hmm.
wasn't really running away. I just wanted to get to a safe place. A place I'd been before.
Steven,
okay.
It sounds
angle,
like...
Bangle.
Finally.
Wow. Okay, who's here. Next? All right, kiddo, it's time for bed. We got a big day tomorrow.
What's tomorrow?
The Forest March. Every year we climb the mountain all the way to the top. It's the end of the summer, Belle.
Holly?
Knife.
Steven, hey, why don't you take this for a while?
What am I, a mule?
Stubborn as. Here.
Whoa! Are there bricks in here? A flashlight? It's broad daylight, Dad. GPS? I mean, it's cool and all, but we're on the trail.
Well, what if the fog rolls in? What if it starts to rain?
You bring umbrellas, too? How about a pasta maker and a bread machine?
Steven, you want to know why we keep you on a short leash?
Why?
Because you think you're indestructible.
I am indestructible.
Ah, give up.
What is true?
Hollis, come on. Come on, sweetie, we're almost there.
I've never climbed as high before.
I know.
Oh. View's all right, I guess.
Wonderful.
Don't you think so, Hollis?
Fun here this summer? No, scratch that.
Yeah.
Holly, have you felt at home here this summer?
It's been great. Thank you.
Of course, this is the summer. It's the cabin. Circumstances are idyllic.
Idyllic?
All right, knock it off, buddy. But, you know, it isn't always easy for families far from it. There's, in life, lots of stresses and strains.
I think what John's trying to say is that we really enjoyed having you here this summer, Hollis, and we hope you've enjoyed it too, but all families have...
It's okay. I knew this was just for the summer.
No, sweetie, that's not what we're trying to say at all. It's...
Okay, what they're trying to get at is they want to adopt you.
Steven.
We want you to live with us. I mean, maybe it's better to say we want you in our family. I mean, we think of you as part of our family already, and we want to make it official.
We love you, Holly. I knew there would be crying.
So, what do you say?
We'll say yes already. We have cake and ice cream.
Yes.
Oh. That's right. Over here.
Well, sis.
When people say they feel like they're floating, I know what they mean. That's the way I felt that day. Now it was only a memory.
Wake up, Josie. We're here now.
Okay. Oh. Come on. Anne, are you?
Come on.
Where's B? She's my best lifelong friend, you know.
Not counting Henry.
Not counting Henry. You hear that, Henry?
Where are we?
This is where I used to live. Before I messed everything up.
When's B coming with supper? I'm hungry. She should be here.
I'm looking for something for us to eat right now.
How old were we?
Josie, there's no food here. I look like the abominable snowman. I'm going to catch some fish. You like fish?
Goldfish? I had one in a bowl. Thank. But I couldn't trust Henry.
To eat, I mean, for us.
I'd never eat a goldfish.
Stay here. Please. Come on, fishy. Be nice. Take a little bite.
I stood alone in that river thinking, if only I had gone fishing with Stephen that day.
So, come with me.
Well, you like hiking, so come with me.
Oh yeah, an hour of walking followed by a day of watching you draw.
It's our last day. I've got stuff to finish.
Okay, be that way. So I guess this is goodbye?
Well, shut up.
Okay, whatever you do, be back by 3. Folks are taking us into civilization.
If I'm late, just come pick me up.
Yeah, right.
Thank you.
Do you know what time it is?
Is it late?
Sorry, I was drawing the valley for Izzy.
Kissing up already. Get in.
Whatever you do, don't tell Dad about the truck, okay? He'll freak.
Slow down.
I know.
Slow down!
I know, I'm trying.
Steven, slow down!
I'm trying!
I was always told I brought trouble to the people around me. The way that summer ended had finally made me believe it.
Josie, I didn't catch anything. Josie?
Time I'd lost everything important to me. I'd made a mess of everything. Again.
Stephen. Stephen Regan? How is he?
It's gonna be okay, honey. Just relax.
Okay, I need you to take some deep breaths. Let's get a full CT with contrast.
How's Stephen? How are you feeling, huh?
Where is he?
I'm keeping a real close eye on him.
Please tell Mr. Regan not to be mad at him. It wasn't his fault, it was mine. It was all because of me.
I was late. I told him to bring the truck.
Nobody's blaming anybody, okay? Nobody.
Monkey, you lay your head back down. You try to get some rest, all right? You're okay.
I'm sorry Stephen was hurt so badly. I don't think I should stay with you anymore.
Thank you.
I'm sorry for messing up your family. I don't want to love anybody anymore. And I don't want anybody to love me. Yours sincerely,
Hollis Woods.
Every time I see her, she asks about your son.
Hollis so clearly belongs in your family, but I gotta warn you, she's on the run emotionally, and I've had a hard time reaching her.
Holly?
Mr. Regan drove all the way from Hancock to see you.
Stephen is coming home soon. He's gonna be okay. And he and Izzy send their love. Oh, and they brought you something that's yours. There's your pictures and your pencils. Look, Hollis, I need you to understand something. No one blames you for what happened. Okay? You're part of our family, and we love you. You see? You see that? That's where you belong. We want you to come back home.
I think I'll stay here.
What is going on in your mind, Holly? Believe me, whatever it is, we can all work through it together. I love you, Holly.
I don't know what to say.
Well, will you stay in touch with us and let us know how she's doing?
Yeah.
Maybe she'll change her mind.
I have had sympathy for you, Hollis Woods. I realize that you have had some hard knocks early on, but I am going to tell you the truth, my dear. Are you listening? You're a coward. When things aren't perfect, you run.
Where did you get the idea that families are supposed to be perfect?
That's real. I'm gonna tell you something that I do know, and trust me, I know it for sure. You gotta take a chance, Hollis. You gotta be willing to risk. Don't think that I don't see you. I know you. I have known you a long time. I know that you try to play it safe. If you don't risk anything, you won't lose anything. Look at me. Hollis, here's the hard fact. Every one of us will eventually lose everyone we love. So there's no time to waste.
Edna was right. I had lost the Regans. That day in the woods, I didn't want to lose Josie, too.
Look! I found us a Christmas tree. Let's go decorate it.
This. Ugly, isn't it?
Oh, I like this.
Huh? Holly for my Hollis.
You know how I got my name? It's a real place. In Queens. That's where they found me. Just an hour old.
And look at you now.
Oh. Sit down. And close your eyes. Close them. No peeking.
Okay. It's from Santa. Oh.
It's beautiful.
She has your long, giving arms and your beautiful wild hair. Do you think she looks like you?
Not as tough.
Wish you could see yourself the way I do.
Oh, you close your eyes now. Oh.
Closed.
Okay. Open. You and B.
You've made us look so young and glamorous. Oh, I miss B.
I know.
She remembers things for me.
I forget things, Hollis. Sometimes things seem so clear, and then I'm scared. Never been sick a day in my life.
You're not sick. Everyone forgets stuff sometimes.
It's more than forgetting. I don't think I can.
Ready to go?
Almost.
Josie?
What?
Did you board that up?
No. That was a friend.
What friend?
Oh, you just missed him. He left you something. Candy bar.
Why didn't you let me know you were here?
I didn't want to scare you off. Last time you saw Dad, you told him to take a flying hike.
I messed up everything. For you and Izzy and John.
Hollis, you were so thick sometimes.
How did you know I was here?
Miss Riley called us.
Edna?
She said you were a missing person. I was just hoping we'd know where you were. I told Dad you'd be right here at the cabin. Did he listen? No. He went to Long Island with Edna to find you.
Edna and John are out looking for me?
I miss you, Holly.
I missed you too. I missed all of you.
Well, then can we let the folks know what's going on? Are you ready for this? She's gonna freak.
Hello?
Hey, Mom, it's me. Can you drive out to the cabin right
the
away?
Cabin. What's going on at the cabin? Are you okay?
No, Mom. I'm fine.
Is the cabin okay?
Yes, the cabin's fine too. So is Hollis.
Oh my gosh! Hollis, you're with Hollis? Is she okay? I'm coming right now.
Sorry, I know I should have asked for
more. No. It's okay. Everything's okay now.
Is it all right if I come home?
Are you kidding me? Of course you're coming home.
I'd like you to meet my best friend.
Okay.
She's inside.
Right.
So you're gonna be here, and Hollis, and who else?
Steven. My husband, John. I told you about John.
Edna, you know Edna. So we'll all be here together, and it should be lovely.
That's right. We'll have a little party.
I don't know why we don't do this more often.
Well, you come to our house.
Miss Riley and Dad are here.
Oh, great. That's my husband. I told you about, and Edna.
Oh, yes, and Edna.
Oh, Hollis, I missed you so much.
I have something I want to say to Edna.
Okay.
Thank you.
John.
Henry's been my buddy for a long time.
Aw, nice you? Fire, Dad.
Your eyes match.
Oh, that's awesome. Hey, could you make one of me?
Oh, well, these things take time, you know.
I love this tree.
So good.
Me too.
Okay. Excuse me.
Whoa, it even has
a
backpack
14th
on.
Christmas this year.
Awesome.
Hello?
Hey, it's Josie
Claire. Yes, she is right here. They both are, and they're fine.
Good. May I talk to her?
Josie, I have someone here who wants to talk to you.
Oh, thank you. Hello?
The whole world's been looking for you.
Beatrice, where are you?
I'm on my way, and I think it's time we live together again, like we did when we were kids.
That sounds nice.
Only this time, we each get our own room.
Crazy Bee.
Who's with you now?
Oh, I'm with Hollis and, let's see. I don't know, Bee, but they seem like very nice people.
How's your Christmas?
Oh, we had a good Christmas. But Henry and I are ready to come home now.
Well, I can't wait. I'll see you tonight.
Okay, Bee. Goodbye. It's Beatrice.
Was it?
That was Beatrice.
Josie went home to be, and I went home with the Regans. It was a very Merry Christmas. I have a new last name now. Hollis Woods Regan. But as often as I can, I still visit Josie Kale. She doesn't exactly remember who I am. She loves me, though. I know that. Sometimes she reaches up and touches my cheek. "You saved my life," she says. And I always tell her, "No, it was the other way around."